today three really cool ways on how to use vectors or vector brushes for your graphic design work. I'm going to walk you through with detail on how to use brushes or vector brushes in today's Satori Graphics graphic design tutorial. What is up, people? Welcome back to Satori Graphics, the home of graphic design content right here on YouTube. So today, three cool ways on how you can use vectors or vector brushes for your graphic design work. So let's waste no more time and let's jump right into today's video on how to use vector brushes or vectors in your graphic design work. The first way to use Illustrator vector brushes is going to be a very neat way to add to a design such as this. This vector brush technique is also good for specific logo designs and so much more. You need to open up the brush window here, or you can simply press F5 on your keyboard. You will see a collection of brushes here, which we can add to, but also you can drag and drop the brushes into the trash can in the bottom right corner to delete them. For our vector brush today, we're going to create a perfect square with the rectangle tool by holding down shift. You then need to lock the square down in place, as we're going to use it as a guide. Press P to locate the pen tool and then draw along the guide all the way around the square but not fully, and then come in a little bit into the middle somewhat like so. Select off of the pen tool path with V, and then drag the shape away and unlock everything. You can now delete the square because we don't need it anymore. Increase the stroke weight, and then with the direct selection tool, you can drag the line at the top and the middle across a little bit. We're going to make a pattern border with this design by using vector brushes in Illustrator, so make sure you have a decent size and stroke weight for your design. With the shape selected, go to the brush window, and in the top right corner, click New Brush, and then we need to use Pattern Brush. You're going to be met with a whole host of options, but today we're going to use the Stretch to Fit, and also the Tints option. You can rename your brush to something relevant and then click OK. You can then double click your brush in the window to adjust it at any stage. So for example, I made a typo on this brush name, which I can change quickly. So in what way can we use this vector brush? To make a border on this design, we simply need to take the rectangle tool and make a rectangle across the entire canvas. With it highlighted, simply click your brush and the pattern will be placed around the border. I've chosen the wrong setting. I want to use tints only so I can adjust the color as I want to. We can then adjust the position, the size, and the stroke of the border. I think this is a great way to use Illustrator vector brushes, and it looks really neat. This next way to use Illustrator vector brushes relates to typography. I've got some vector paint splatters here that you can find in my digital download section on my website, which is linked below, but you can also use any vectors for this technique. Copy the vector with Command or Control C, and then copy it over to your artboard and paste it in with Command or Control V. So again, open up the brush window by pressing F5 on your keyboard, and then go ahead and add a new brush. But this time we want to use an artistic brush. For this way to use vector brushes, we'll be using the stretch to fit length. As before, use the tints option, and then hit OK. With the brush tool, you can draw and your vector will fit along the path. But also you can draw a line with the pen tool and click the brush in the window. You can resize your point brush stroke and edit the color. And when you're done, go ahead and outline the stroke. If you then go up to Object, Compound Path and Make, you'll be able to perform the next step in this tutorial. You can then select both the topography and the brush stroke, and then right or control click and make clipping mask. Press Command or Control Z to undo it and edit the stroke to try a different layout. You can also add a clipping mask by going up to Object at the top. You can also take multiple vector brushes or brush strokes and then unite them in the Pathfinder window and use this to overlay topography. You can have so much fun with this and spend more time than I'm doing in this tutorial to make some really cool outcomes with this way to use Illustrator vector brushes. The last way to use Illustrator vector brushes might be my favorite, and it relates to logo design. So here I have a collection of different vector splatters that I've created. And as I said before, you can download them for yourself on my website, but you can do this with any single vector you want. To make this work, you need to make sure that your logo is united in the Pathfinder window as one object. Also, you need to create a compound path on the logo as we previously did with the topography section. Lastly, bring the logo to the front of all layers and make sure it is actually the most forward layer on your artboard. Then, as we did before, select everything and create a clipping mask. This can produce some really cool outcomes. You can select everything and hold down Shift and click the logo to deselect it, and then you can rotate and edit the vectors. This is a very quick logo that I've made here, but you can spend time to see what kind of designs you can come up with using vector brushes in Illustrator. And then finally, to add some logo type to the design. Again, this is something you want to spend a lot of time doing because it is important to get right. I'm just mocking something up in a hurry for the purposes of today's tutorial on ways to use Illustrator vector brushes. And there you have it, a logo design using vector brushes. And it does look pretty neat if you ask me.
So there is today's video on how to use vectors or vector brushes on your graphic design work. Let me know what you thought of today's video in the comment section below, and also leave a like if you did enjoy it. If you really want to help out my channel, share this video on social media, and also give me a subscribe if you haven't done already. I upload graphic design content on a weekly basis, just like today's video. So until next time, design your future today. Peace.